Hi students, this is Rajendra. Welcome to Rajendra Reddy Chemistry Point. In previous classes, we discussed about Lewis dot structures. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about Lewis structures for some of the organic molecules. So the first one is CH4. That is, what is CH4? CH4 is nothing but methane. It is known as methane. So let us write methane Lewis dot structure. So before writing the Lewis dot structure of the methane, we have to know that Lewis dots for some of the symbols, means some of the elements. Carbon, this is a Lewis dot structure for the carbon. So means here carbon, the symbol is C and it has 4 valence electrons, so 4. And hydrogen, so this is a Lewis dot structure for hydrogen. Symbol H, it has only 1 valence electron. Now this is a symbol for oxygen, so O, which has 2 unpaired electrons and as well as 2 paired electrons. This is the Lewis dot symbol for oxygen. Now this is Lewis dot symbol for nitrogen. It has 1 paired, 3 unpaired electrons. This is a Lewis dot symbol for the sulfur, which has 2 paired, 2 unpaired electrons. Now let us write Lewis dot structure for the CH4, methane. So here, in case of methane, so the C in the middle, we have carbon. So only one carbon atom is there. That should be in the middle. And more, how many hydrogens are there here? 4 hydrogens are there. 1, 2, 3, and as well as 4. 4 hydrogens are there. So here, for one carbon, so it has 4 dots, means 4 valence electrons. Now for each hydrogen, which have 1 valence electron. Now, due to pairing of this electron, it leads to formation of the bond. Due to pairing of these electrons, it leads to formation of the bond. So it leads to formation of methane. CHHH. This is the formation of the methane. So carbon forms 4 single bonds with 4 hydrogens. So this carbon gains. Now this carbon has how many electrons? 2. 4 twos are 8 electrons. So this got octet configuration. So this is stable. The carbon is stable by octet configuration. Now hydrogen has how many electrons? 2 electrons. So it has duplet configuration. So it is stable. Let us write Lewis dot structure for the ethane. So here, first of all, meth. Meth means 1 carbon. Eth means 2 carbons. So here we have to consider here also. Number of carbons. If number of carbon is 1, then it starts with the meth. Number of carbons are 2, starts with eth. Number of carbons are 3, starts with prop. Number of carbons are 4, start with but. 5, pent. 6, hex. So here, let us consider methane. So here, meth. Meth means only 1 carbon. So 1 carbon, 4 hydrogens. Ethane. Eth means 2 carbons. If the number of carbons are 2, it starts with the name starts with the eth. So here let us write ethane. So how many carbons are there? First, write the number of carbons on a straight line. 2 carbons are there. So here we have 2 carbons. Now each carbon has how many electrons? 4 valence electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just in order to represent perfectly, just we are taking S cross mark. One is as a dot, one is as a cross. So here, between 2 carbons, a bond is formed that leads to formation of a single bond, that is sigma. That is sigma. We will discuss about sigma and pi bonds in next classes. So here, how many hydrogens are there? 6 hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hydrogens are there. So here we have 6 hydrogens. So here, cross mark, dot, 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 dot. Here a pair, here also 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 a pair. Now you can consider here, in between the 2 carbons, how many bonds we have? 1 bond, means a pair of electrons. Now each carbon is bonds with how many hydrogens? 3 hydrogens, 1 hydrogen, 2 hydrogens, 3 hydrogens. This carbon also bonds with 3 hydrogens, 1, 2, 3. Now, this is the structure of the ethane. Now here you can consider whether the carbons are got stable or not. So the carbons are stable. You can see here, this carbon has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This got octet configuration. It is stable. This is octet. Now this carbon got how many electrons? It has 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This also got octet configuration. It is also stable. Now this is the structure of ethane. So here in the ethane, between the two carbons only single bond is there. So this is. So now you can observe total how many. Each single bond is nothing but a sigma bond. Just simply you consider. Here this carbon forms how many bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sigma bonds. This carbon forms 4 single bonds. 4 single bonds. Nothing but 4 sigma bonds. This carbon also forms how many bonds? 4 single bonds. 4 single bonds means 4 sigma bonds. Okay. Now you can simply here this, you have how many bonds here? 4 single bonds. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sigma bonds are there. So this is about the CH4 and C2H6. Next structure is ethene. So here two carbons are there. You have to represent two carbons here. One's first carbon, second carbon, and as well as four hydrogens are there. Whatever the number of hydrogens, you have to distribute uniformly. Two for this carbon and two for this carbon. So here H and as well as H. Here also H, H. Now hydrogens are distributed here. So hydrogen distribution is also over. Now this is formation of a bond. 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 Now between the two carbons, how many electrons are remain here? So this carbon remains two electrons. This carbon remains two electrons. Now here these two electrons are get a pair. These two electrons will get combined together from a pair. Now here it leads to formation of C. How many bonds are there between the two carbons? Between the two carbons we have two bonds. C double bond C. And here one hydrogen, and here one hydrogen, and here one hydrogen, and here one hydrogen. So this carbon, now this carbon has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stable. This carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is also got stability. So this got octet configuration. This also got octet configuration. So these two are got stability. Now here, between the two carbons, two get stability. Actually, here only one bond is enough. But why it forms two bonds? When it forms only one bond, it has only seven electrons. So it is not stable. So to get stability, it again forms the one more bond. Same, this carbon also like that. So between the two carbons, how many bonds are there now? Two bonds are there. In the two bonds, if between the two atoms, if two bonds are there, in that one bond definitely sigma, another bond definitely pi. Means in between the two atoms, only one sigma bond is there. If more than one bond, whatever the bonds are there, those are considered as the pi bonds. So between the two carbons, one sigma bond is there and as well as one pi bond is also there. So these are sigma bonds only, sigma. Okay. So this is about the ethane. Now next, let us discuss about the C2H2, ethyne. So ethyne. So in case of the ethyne, so this carbon and as well as this carbon. So each carbon has how many electrons? Four electrons. So just two for our convenience. One, two, three electrons. Here one electron. One, two, three electrons. Here one electron. Now how many hydrogens are there? Two hydrogens. You distribute the two hydrogens equally. Here one H, here one hydrogen. So here one electron, here also one electron. This is formation of a bond. This leads to formation of a bond. Now this carbon has how many electrons now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 electrons. Is it stable? No, it is not stable. We have to make it stability. How it is possible? So here, for example, now these two are get paired, for example. Now carbon has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons only. It is not stable. It does not got octet configuration. Now for example, overlapping of this bond. Now how many electrons it has? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 only. So it is also not stable. Now again pairing of this electrons. Now what happened? This carbon have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stable. This also got octet configuration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, due to pairing of electrons like this, means it leads to formation of octet configuration and get stability. So, we can represent simply like this, C triple bond C hydrogen, less hydrogen. In between two atoms, if three bonds are there, then one is compulsory sigma, and whatever the two are there, those are pi bonds only. So those are pi bonds only. One sigma bond is there and two pi bonds are there. This is a representation of ethyne. Now let us represent this form C2H5OH. This is ethyl alcohol. Now how can we represent this? Let us see once. So how many carbons are there? Two carbons are there. So first carbon and as well as second carbon. Okay. So here each carbon has how many electrons? Here four electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now two carbons are over. Next one, oxygen is also there. So here oxygen. Oxygen has how many valence electrons? Means two are unpaired electrons. So two carbons are over. One oxygen is over. And as well as next to hydrogens. Let us see here. So between these two, it's formation of a bond. Between these two, it is formation of a bond. Now more. Here oxygen. This has how many valence electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 only. It does not get stability. It requires more one electron to get stability. So that one hydrogen is comes to here. Ikkada oka hydrogen vachesindi. Vachese em chestundi? Din electron ikkada ichesi ikkada pairing ipindi. Now you can consider here this duplet. This got duplet configuration. Two electrons in valence orbit is stable. So duplet. Now this oxygen got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this octet get octet configuration. So it is stable. Now look at this carbon. This carbon has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. Requires more two electrons. So for that, now from here one hydrogen, from here another hydrogen comes. So that what happened? So this is the pairing. This is also a pairing. Now this carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. Now this get octet configuration and it is stable. Okay. Now here this carbon has now how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only. Requires more 3 electrons. More 3 electrons that comes from 3 hydrogens. So here one hydrogen, here one hydrogen, here also one hydrogen. So it leads to an electron. It's a pair. So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This also got octet configuration. So it is stable. So this is a representation. This we can represent like this also. C, H, 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 C, H, H, O, H. So now here, this is a representation. So this is one type of representation. Another is also possible. So what is that? Let us consider oxygen is in the middle. In the middle, oxygen is there. This is one type of representation. In another type, oxygen is in the middle. So from that oxygen, from here one carbon is there. So how it is formed? Let us see once. So for this carbon, oxygen, two are paired. Now for this carbon, four are unpaired electrons. Okay. Now it leads to formation of a bond. Okay. Now here, this oxygen got stability due to octet configuration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. So this is octet. Okay. Now coming to the carbon. It has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only. It requires more 3 electrons. So it forms bond with 3 hydrogens. So from here, one hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. So here, electron, electron, electron. So pair. This carbon has now how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is get octet configuration. So stable. Now from this carbon, so we have only 5 electrons. Needs more 3 electrons to get stability. So from one hydrogen, one electron, another hydrogen, one electron, another hydrogen, another electron. So 3 hydrogens gives 3 electrons. So that 3 pairs are formed. Now this carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. So this get octet configuration. Okay. octet. Now this is stable. So this we can simply represent like this also. C H H H O C H H H. Now here you can see here C2H5OH is the molecule. C2H5 is the molecule. So for this molecule, now here two carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hydrogens, 6 hydrogens, 1 oxygen. So with the same formula, 2 carbons, 1 oxygen, 6 hydrogens. Now which one is correct? This one or this one? Now we can say both are correct. Formula is same, but the compounds are different. Now this is considered as the alcohol. Alcohol. Now this is the ether. This is the ether. Both are correct. The formulas are correct, but the arrangement of the molecules are different. Now these two are the isomers with each other. We will discuss in the next chapter. Let us represent this molecule in different ways. So the formula is C3H6O. So here how many carbons are there? First of all, we have three carbons. One, two, three. Three carbons. And one oxygen is also there. So here, this is. So the next, each carbon has how many electrons? Four valence electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now oxygen has two unpaired electrons and as well as two paired electrons. Now here let us consider between these carbons a bond is formed. All these bonds are formed. Okay, over. Now this oxygen has how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 valence electrons. So it is not stable. To get stability, it requires more one electron. So for that, one hydrogen is came to here and as well as it leads to formation of a bond between these two. It leads to formation of a bond. Now, oxygen gets stability. So, octet. Octet. How? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. And hydrogen get duplet configuration. So, it is stable. Okay. So, first of all, you need to arrange the all the atoms along with Lewis structures. Then, try to get stability. Means, we have to make the atoms stable by adding hydrogens or what by adding the bonds, whatever it may be. So these two get stable. Now this carbon, look at this carbon. Here this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6 electrons are there. It is not stable. Okay. So if you want to get stable this, so more how many electrons are required? 2 electrons are required. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. So 2 electrons. Let us consider for these two electrons, two hydrogens are added. One is from here, one is from here. So now this carbon is stable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this carbon get octet configuration. So it is stable. So octet. So now we have to consider now total three carbons. 1, 2, 3 carbons. One oxygen. One oxygen is came here. So hydrogens are 6. 1, 2, 3. All the three came. We remain only ఇంకా త్రీ హైడ్రోజన్స్ మాత్రమే ఉన్నాయి. సో హియర్ హౌ వీ హౌ టు అరేంజ్. ఇక్కడ టూ ఇచ్చామనుకోండి. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్. వీ కాంట్ స్టేబుల్ దిస్ వన్. సో దట్ వాట్ యూ హౌ టు డూ. సో లెట్ అస్ గివ్ హియర్ టూ హైడ్రోజన్స్. సో హియర్ టూ హైడ్రోజన్స్ ఇక్కడ ఇచ్చేసేసాయి. సో నౌ దిస్ కార్బన్ హ్యాస్ 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఓన్లీ. దిస్ కార్బన్ హ్యాస్ 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. Now is it stable? No, it is not stable. Let us involve, there is a formation of, let us consider there is a formation of a bond here. Another more bond between the two carbons. Now, look at here. This carbon is stable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. So this got octet configuration. So this is stable. Octet, stable. But coming to here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 electrons only. It requires more one electron. So to get that, it forms bond with hydrogen. So now this also got stability. So octet. So stable. Now simply you can represent like this. So C double bond C. So two bonds are now. One is sigma bond, another is pi bond. And one more C. So for this carbon, two hydrogens are there. So O H. Okay. So first this carbon, how many hydrogens are there? One. Two. This carbon bonds with two hydrogens and two bonds, and this carbon has only one hydrogen. This carbon has two hydrogens. This is the way of representation. So this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stable. This is stable. This is also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stable. This carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stable. isosin is stable. This one is also stable. This is one type of structure which is formed from this molecule. So here, let us consider for another type of structure which is formed. So possibilities, it is depends on whatever the structures we are writing, it is depends on our knowledge. All these are possibilities. So three carbons, one, two, three. Three carbons are there. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 3 carbons, 12 valence electrons. Now let us see here, let us consider these 6 hydrogens are there. Na? So here 3 hydrogens are forms bonds here. 1, 2, 3. So it is formation of 3 bonds from this carbon. Add here also 1, 2, 3. So it is formation of the more 3 bonds. 1, 2, 3. Over. Now between these two carbons there is a bond, here also a bond. Now this carbon get octet configuration, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So this is octet, say stabilities. This also got octet, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 octet, and it is also a stable. But here this carbon is not stable, this carbon is not stable, and we remain one oxygen also. 6 hydrogens are completed and 3 carbons also completed, 1 2 3. Remain only one oxygen is there. For that, it leads to formation of bond like this. So this is the oxygen. Now two are unpaired. Now two are paired. Now it has two unpaired electrons from this carbon. So this is formation of a bond. This is formation of a bond. Okay. So this is here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons are there. So this carbon is get stability. We can simply write like this also. C double bond bow. So these two are electrons. And from here C, H, 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 C, H, H, H. This is also one possibility. So this is the, from this molecule, these two structures are possible. Not only these two, the third one is also possible. Let us see what is the third one. So third one, how it is possible? Let us see once. So here, one carbon, two carbons, three carbons. Okay. So all have electrons, single electrons. So here there is a bond, okay, and here also there is a bond, okay. So now let us consider 6 hydrogens are here, total 6 hydrogens. From that 3 hydrogens are forms a bond like this. Here is one bond, this is also one bond, from here also one bond. So here from this again hydrogen, one bond, hydrogen, one bond. So these bonds are over. Now how many? 1 2 3 3 carbons are over. 1 2 3 3 hydrogens are over. Again 2 hydrogens, 5 hydrogens are over, remaining one oxygen, one hydrogen. So far the, let us consider there is a direct involvement of hydrogen like this. This is a possibility. So and here from these two electrons, so there is one oxygen, two unpaired electrons, two paired electrons. This is to formation of a bond like this. Okay. So now you can consider your this carbon, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Here this also, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So it is stable. This also, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, it is also stable. So now this got octet. Now this also, here also we got octet. This also got octet. This also got octet. So these are stable. If you want write like this structure, simply, we can write like this. H, 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 double bond, H. These are, this is the structure. Now with these, with this molecule, one more possibility is also there. Let me check it. So fourth one more possibility is also there. So I'm simply writing here like this. So carbon, carbon, and here also a carbon, here also a oxygen. Okay. So here 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, and here two are paired, two are unpaired. So here this is involvement of a bond, this is involvement of a bond, this is involvement of a bond, this is involvement of a bond. Okay. And from here hydrogen, 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 pair, 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 pair. So simply we can represent like this also. C C C O O H2 H2 H2. So these are four types of possibilities are there. Even the formula is same, but by using the same hydrogen, oxygen and carbon, we are representing these four types of structures here. Now here simply we can consider this is alcohol, okay, along with double bond. Now this is ketone structure, ketone, this is a functional group, is ketone. Now this is aldehyde. Now this is cyclic ether. Now this is about the possible structure from this. Like that you can draw so many of the structure. All these are correct. All these are one by one. All these are isomers to each other. We will discuss about isomers in the next class. Okay. From this carbon, from this molecule, we could able to write structures like this. All structures we could able to write. As your knowledge, you try to write the following structures. Okay. You try to write Lewis structure for the following molecules. So first one, C2H5NH2. First one. And second one, C3H8. Third one, C4H10. Fourth one, C3H6. Fifth one, C5H12OH. Okay, try to write possible Lewis dot structures with these formulas. Okay, right. Thank you for watching. ఈ వీడియో కనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, కామెంట్ చేయండి, మన ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి.